Welcome once again to all of you. Today we are going ahead with the third video of the Ashtanga Hridaya Sutra Sthana, and we are going to start with the topic Tri Dosha Vaishishtya, that is Tri Dosha and their importance. So Vagvata says, Vayu Pittam Kafas Cheti Trayo Dosha Samasataha Vikrita Avikrita Deham Granthite Vartayanti Cha. That means Vata, Pitta and Kapha are the three doshas of the body. The perfect balance of these three doshas lead to health, and imbalance in three dosha leads to the disease. So this particular shloka can be explained by making this small chart, that is Vata, Pitta, Kapha. When they are vitiated, then they destroys the body, that is Deham Ghananti. And when these doshas are avikrit or not vitiated, they maintains the health of the individual. So Vata, Pitta and Kapha, these are the core factors or the important pillars of the body. So if I explain you, so Vata, Pitta and Kapha are also called as by the name three pillars of the body. Vata, Pitta and Kapha. So these three doshas should always in a balanced state, and whenever the balance spoils, it leads to the imbalance of the doshas, and that result into the disease condition. So that's why one should try to maintain the balance of the three doshas. So if they are balanced, then it will result into the health of the individual. As per the commentators, Arun Datta says, Dushyanti iti dosha. What is dosha? Dosha is the one which spoils or which vitiates. Sushut Sutra, 15th chapter, the name of the chapter itself is Dosha Dhatu Malakshaya Vriddhi Vigyaniyam Adhyaya. And he says Dosha Dhatu Mala Moolam Hi Shariram. Dosha, Dhatu and Malas are the Moola or the base for this Sharira. And he defines the health as Samadosha, Samagnisha, Samadhatu, Malakriyaha, Prasannatmendriya Manaha, Swastha Itya Vidhiyate. So this is the definition of health given by Ayurveda, and it is from Sushruta Samhita. So it is very important for us to remember this particular shloka, that is samadoshaha, when doshas are in normal stage, sama agni, when the digestive fire in the normal stage, samadhatu, when the body tissues are in the balanced state, malakriya, when the malakriya or the expulsion of malas is proper, prasannatmendriya manaha, when there is happiness in the mind, swasthitya vidhiyate, that is called as the state of swastha. So if we see it further, we can explain this condition as Vata, Pitta, Kapha, that is three doshas, Vata, Pitta and Kapha, seven dhatus are rasarakta mamsmed asti macha, three malas. If there is balance in the three doshas, when there is balance in the body tissues, and when there is proper expulsion of three malas, plus when there is healthy mind, so these things together called as the health. So that is samadosha. Then one more thing was there, agni. So samadosha, samagni, samadhatu, samamala and mind. When these things are proper, it result into the health of the individual. So tridosha is one of the important concept of Ayurveda, which everybody must know. Now coming to the next shloka, that is dosha sthana. What is the place of these three doshas? Vagbhata says, Te vyapinaha api hrit nabhyo adho madhya urdhva samshraya. So this shloka I have written after doing sandhi vichet, but if you are reading the shloka, it will come as Te vyapino api hrit nabhyo adho madhya urdhva samshraya. So if you want to behead the shloka, you should split the word, that is Te vyapinaha api hrit nabhyo adho madhya urdhva samshraya. That means Although the doshas are present all over the body, but their location can be below nabhi is a place for vata, between nabhi and epigastrium is pitta, and above epigastrium is the place of kapha dosha. But we should remember that doshas are present all over the body, but these are the main sthana or the site of the three doshas. Now coming to the dosha prakopa kala, the time of vishesan of three doshas. Vayo ahoratri bhuktanam teyanta madhyadigaha kramat. That is, vaya ahoratri bhuktanam teyanta madhyadigaha kramat. So vaya means the age, aho means day, ratri means night, bhuktana means food, anta means end, madhya means middle, adi means starting, kramat means in particular order. So now we will understand this particular shloka by the mean of this table. So we have to divide these factors. So first is vaya, that is age, aho, day, ratri, night, bhuktanam, that is food. So now te anta madhya adhiga kramat. So vata, pitta and kapha. So anta means the end of the age, that is old age. End of the day, that is anta of the aho or day is evening. End of night is late night. End of food is after the digestion. So te anta madhya adhiga kramat. Now this is the end of the age, end of the day, end of the night, end of the food. Now in between age, in the mid of the day, mid of the night and mid of digestion, that is during digestion. Then about age, starting of the age, that is adi, starting of the day, that is morning, starting of the night, early night, and starting of the food, that is before digestion. So that is the state of three doshas in the different aspect. So end of the age, that is in old age, vata will be more. In the evening time, again vata will be more. In the late night, vata will be more. And after digestion, vata will be more. Now during the madhyaga, that is in between the age, that is in the young stage or the youth, the vata pitta will be more. In the midday, pitta will be more. Midnight, pitta will be more. And during digestion of the food, pitta will be more. Because pitta is nothing but the agni. And for the digestion of the food, agni is required. Now starting of the life, that is childhood age, kapha is more. Early morning, kapha is more. Early night, kapha is more. And before digestion, kapha is more. So that's why to understand this particular shloka, you can bahat it. First understand, then you should bahat. Then you can easily write your own regarding the explanation of this particular shloka. So this is nothing but the physiological. So there is no pathology in this. So these all things are common which happens in the all the individuals. Now coming to the next shloka, that is types of agni. Tair bhavet vishmas tikshno mandas agni samahi samaha. If you split these words, it will come tahi bhavet vishmaha tikshno manda agni samahi samaha. Tahi bhavet vishmaha tikshno manda agni samahi samaha. Depending upon the state of dosha, there are four types of agni, that is visham agni, tikshna agni, mand agni and sama agni. Sama is the normal, all the healthy agni. That agni should be optimum or proper. Dominance of doshas. For visham agni, vata is responsible. For tikshna agni, pitta is responsible. For mand agni, kapha is responsible. For sama agni, there should be sama dosha. Now coming to the next shloka, which is related with the previous shloka, that is types of kosta. Kosta kruro mridur madhyo madhya syat tahi samahi api. If you do the sandhi vichhed, it will come as kosta krura mridu madhya madhya syat tahi samahi api. So there are three types of kosta: krura, mridu and madhya. Krur kosta because of vata dosha, mridu kosta because of pitta dosha, and madhya kosta is because of kapha dosha. So this is the kosta actually, not agni. So now if you want to understand it further, you can easily understand by this following explanation. So the concept of kosta and agni is very, very important in Ayurveda. The word kosta has been used in different contexts. So the kosta word is used as anatomical location, and it is also used as physiological entity. So in this context, Vagbhata has used the word kosta as, the word kosta is used as physiological entity. So kosta, actually in anatomical aspect, it is nothing but the GI tract. This is the GI tract. So this whole thing is called as kosta. And what the organs are situated here, those organs are called as kosta anga or kosta avayava, or in modern terminology you can understand it as, these are nothing but the organs. So now, what is about the agni and where this agni is situated? So this is very important thing to understand. Where is the state of agni and what is about these three types of kosta? So you know that to say the position of the agni, acharyas have clearly mentioned. So this, what you see, is the structure of the stomach, and this is the first part of the small intestine. So agni is defined as the place, the site of agni is the, this is called as amashaya in Ayurveda. The stomach in modern science is called by the name amashaya in Ayurveda. This is called as the pakvashaya. Pakva means digested. Ashaya means place. The place where digested food is situated is called as pakvashaya. Amashaya means, it is made up of two words, that is ama plus ashaya. Ama means undigested food, ashaya means the site. So stomach gives the place for the undigested food. So this organ is called as amashaya. So Ayurveda says the location of this agni is the last part of stomach and starting part of the intestine. So this place is the site for the agni, and it is called as pakvamashaya, pakvamashaya madhyagamaha. That is, agni is situated in between pakvashaya, in between the last part of amashaya and starting part of pakvashaya. So it is called as pakvamashaya. So this is the place for this agni. As we have already said, that this agni, it is of different types, and that's why the kosta is also of the different types. So that is the nature of the GI tract, which differs person to person. So some person will be having krura kosta. Krura kosta. If you see the word meaning of krura, in Hindi the word krura means the one who is very cruel. And when we call a person as cruel, that means that person is not doing the work of a human being, what he should do. Same way, the mrdu. Mrdu means, in a simple word, it means saumya, or the one who is very soft. So if I give you any work, homework, you will do properly. We say that this student is very soft nature. So this GI tract is called as cruel when it is not doing its work. Not doing the work. And when the work is done perfectly, we are calling it as mrdu. So in krura kosta, the digestion of the food will not be proper. The person will be always suffering from the constipation. While in mrdu kosta, whatever the person is eating, it is digesting properly, and early morning he can evacuate the bowels. So that's the meaning of mrdu kosta. In summer, this is called as normal kosta. So the food will be, normal food will be digested as per the proper time. In between these two is the summer kosta. It is considered as best. So when we say krura kosta, that means it is always because of vata dosha. When we say mridu kosta, it is always because of pitta dosha, because pitta is nothing but the agni which helps in digestion. If the kosta is mridu, that means the pitta is more, and pitta is more means it will digest the food very easily. And sama means all the three doshas will be in the samya avastha, that is vata, pitta and kapha. Now coming to the next shloka, these are different types of agni. So I have given the reference of Acharya Sushruta, who says tatra mridu kruro madhyama iti trivida kosta bhavati. Kosta is of three types, that is mridu, Krura, Madhyama. These are three types of Kosta mentioned by Sushruta. Mridu Kosta means Tatra Bahu Pitto Mridu. In Mridu Kosta people, as I already explained you, the Pitta will be more. Sa Dugden Api Virichyate. So if you want to test about what are these three types of Kosta, which person is having which type of Kosta, then it is a very simple method to identify. You just, when a person or the patient comes to you, just ask him to take milk before going to bed. So early morning he will get the loose stools. So that shows he is having Mridu Kosta. Now come about the Krur Kosta. Bahu Vata Sleshma Kruraha. In Krur Kosta there is the predominance of Vata and Sleshma. Sa Durvirechya. So he will not get the bowels evacuated so easily. Bahu Vata Sleshma Krura, and there is a dominance of Vata and Kapha. Madhyama Kosta Samadosho Madhyamaha Sa Sadharana. Where all the doshas present in the normal state is called as Madhyam Kosta Sadharana. It is a normal type of Kosta which we expect in a healthy individual. So that is the explanation of Kosta according to Acharya Sushruta. So these three types of Kosta can be identified very easily in the individuals. So as I said, if you want to assess the Kosta in an individual, ask him to take hot milk before going to bed. Or next day morning, if he get the loose stools, that means he is having Mridu Kosta. Still his bowels are constipated. The next day, you give some medicine. And if after giving the medicine, if the person is having loose stools, then it is the Krura Kosta. Now coming to the next sloka, that is Deha Prakriti. It is one of the core principle of Ayurveda about the Prakriti. The word Prakriti, that means the nature. So different individual having different nature, and Ayurveda has explained it as Deha Prakriti. Shukrartha Vasthair Janmadu Vishenava Vishkrimahe Taisha Tisra Prakritiyo In Madhyottamaha Prithak Samadhatu Samastatu Sreshta Nindya Vidosha Jaha. If you want to read this sloka, you have to do Sandhi Vichet. Shukra Arthavasthai Janma Ado Vishene Vishen Eva Vishakrimehe Tehi Chaha Tisra Prakritayo Hina Madhya Uttamaha Prithak Samadhatu Samastatu Sreshta Nindya Dvidoshajaha. Shukra means sperm, Arthava means ovum, Janma means birth, Ado means starting, Vishena, that is Visha or the poisonous, Krimi means insects. Taisya Tisraha Prakritiyo, based upon these three types of Prakriti, that is Hina, Madhyama and Uttama Prakriti. Samadhatu Samastasu Sreshta Nindya Dvidoshaja. Now coming to the meaning of this sloka, the Prakriti of a person is determined at the time of fertilization based on the involvement of Dosha in Shukra and Arthava. So when the sperm and ovum combines and the fertilization happens, that time only the nature of the person will be decided. Just like venom of a poisonous insect inherent to the poisonous offspring, similarly the Prakriti, the body type, is inherent to human beings. So Vata Prakriti is considered as Hina. Hina means which is not good. Pitta Prakriti is Madhyama, that is normal. Kapha Prakriti is considered as Uttama or the best. Tridoshaj Prakriti is Sreshta and Dvidoshaj is Nindya. So Dvidoshaj Prakriti means like person will be having Vata Pitta Prakriti or Vata Kapha or Pitta Kapha or Pitta Vata. So these are Dvidoshaj Prakriti. Those are considered as Nindya. Nindya means which are not good. Tridoshaj Prakriti is considered as best, and out of individual Prakriti, Kapha is considered as best. Now the question is, why the Vata Prakriti is considered as Hina, Pitta is Madhyama and Kapha is Uttama? So in coming chapters, you are going to read it in detail about this concept of Prakriti and nature of the individuals. So I will try to explain you in very short how to understand the concept of these Prakritis. So as you know, the nature of the individual is different. You will be having your friends, your relatives, and you have seen their nature, what kind of people they are. So usually the people of the Vata Prakriti, the person of Vata Prakriti, usually they will be they are not bothered for others. You can say that sometimes you call them they are cunning. For example, when you need any help from your friend, if you need notes in your exam time, these people will not give you. And you will say, this person is very cunning, not helping me. So that is not the mistake of that person. His prakriti is vataj, and vataj prakriti will behave in such a way. Vata prakriti person will be too fast in their action. So you can see some of the individual, they will walk very fast. They will have food very fast. Okay, sometimes you will say them, why are you eating so fast? Eat slowly. So again, this is because of their vataj prakriti. Next is coming the pittaja. Pittaja prakriti is like normal. So sometimes these are very helpful people. Sometimes they will not help. The anger is too much. Some people are, you say that they are short tempered. That is because of their pitta prakriti. Anger will be more. The kapha prakriti people, they are very much cool. They are very much calm. They won't take tensions so easily. They will understand the person very comfortably. They will be helping to others. So that is very important nature. They will help others. So this, in short, this is the feature of the kapha prakriti. So likewise, I will explain you in detail about these characters of the different prakriti in my coming videos.